Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey everyone, welcome to Journey into Next Draft. There are a few pretty reasonable green cards that are staring back at us right now, which is going to make the second pack a bit complicated for us if we take them. We got Hero's Bane, which is just a very large creature. The games that go along, this thing certainly turns into the Abyss, basically killing your opponent in one hit. There's also Golden Hind, which is one of the best commons in the set, just providing a lot of essential mana acceleration that green is desperately in search of. There's also Magma Spray and Bloodcrazed Hoplite, which are not as good as the Golden Hind. And between that and Hero's Bane, I like Golden Hind more because I think that there are a lot of replaceable cards in for a 5-drop, whereas mana acceleration is really what you want. Alright, well, looking at this pack, you can see that there are a few good cards. There's Reprisal, there's Fleet Feather Cockatrice, and then that's about it. The next step down, we've got Fellhead Petrifier, which is pretty reasonable. There's also Grim Guardian and Eagle of the Watch and Supply Line Cranes, which are okay. It's basically Reprisal is the best card, Fleet Feather Cockatrice is the next best card. Being two colors makes it more difficult to play this, but I mean, we don't really have this first card here, so we can't say, well, I've got my first pick, and so I should take the Fleet Feather Cockatrice, because then I can play both. Well, we're not exactly sure if green is open, so we're going to go ahead and just take the best overall card, and then hopefully we end up settling colors for cards that we've already taken so far, and that's Reprisal. The good thing about Reprisal is it deals with some just very nasty large creatures, and sort of like Hubris or Feast of Dreams. Looking at this pack, there appears to be a little bit more black than blue, although it's not really, can't really tell which direction would be best to go in at the moment. Hubris is pretty good at saving your creature, especially if you're dealing with auras. Basically, you can bounce them back to your hand. Crystal Nautilus certainly deserves a bit of talk. It's very good with the any of the constellation creatures. Basically, if you can put this on something and you have something that triggers constellation, the targeted creature that it's enchanting, it instantly turns into a terror. Otherwise, it takes a little bit more work. If anything else, it's just a huge beater, and it's pretty reasonable. But we're going to go ahead and take Feast of Dreams here. It's the better between that and Hubris, so I'm going to go ahead and take that. And looking at this pack, you can see that there's some blue and some, it's kind of difficult to tell which way to go in this pack. We have Warwing Siren, we've got Safer Grove Dancer, there's Consigned to Dust, there's also Squelching Leeches. Doesn't seem like white is as open. It's because I think Warwing Siren is a bit better than Stonewise Fortifier. Black doesn't appear to be as open as either blue or green, so I'm more comfortable taking something like the Grove Dancer or the Consigned to Dust. I'm going to go with the Consigned to Dust just because I think that even I do like Satyr Grove Dancer, but Consigned to Dust has more potential to lead to a blowout, whereas the Grove Dancer is just a solid card. Alright, so here you can see that the black is obviously open. What we're going to do is go ahead and move into black and out of white. Unfortunately, we can't play the Reprisal just yet, it appears, assuming that we end up sticking with green. It appears that black is the color to be in, so we're going to go ahead and stay with that. Take a second Feast of Dreams, and hopefully wheel one of these cards. Probably not going to be the Brain Mag or the Nightmare Shrine of the Cast in Darkness. We might get the font, and I can only hope at this point that not too many other people go into black. Now at this point there's some pretty sweet stuff. There's a Starfish, which we can take, or we can take a Nyx Infusion. Generally not too much of a fan of this card, but it certainly has its uses from time to time. It's just a pretty expensive way to kill a non-enchantment creature. It It's going to be a lot worse than the starfish. However, I feel like between what we have in green, it's going to be better to take. Well, it's better for us that we cut off black at this point. And so if we end up shipping a really good common for like a pretty mediocre middle of the road black common, that's still fine. And here it looks like there's not too much green, so we actually might want to go into blue. But for now, let's see, our options are Solidarity of Heroes, double number of +1/+1 counters on creatures, which gets pretty good with a lot of heroic creatures that are green, and any effects that put +1/+1 counters onto cards. But the blue options are not very interesting, so we could also go with a Deathbringer Lampads, which I think that this is what we're going to go with, since this is pretty mediocre, but we can end up playing it, and if we do, then it's okay. Well, this is certainly interesting. There's Satyr Grove Dancer, which is pretty sweet, but there's also Farika's Chosen. I think we're going to go with the Chosen, just because I know that we're playing green, or rather, I know that we're playing black, and I'm pretty sure that we're playing green, but at the point, having a Death Touch guy is better than having the Grove Dancer. There's also Revel of the Fallen God, which puts a lot of tokens into play, but that's not something that we're going to be concerned with. And there's still a pretty reasonable supply of blue cards, so we can look to blue. It feels like white and red are the least represented colors here. And out of the cards here, there's not really too much that we actually want here. There's maybe a Return Reveler, but that's pretty bad, so we can go with a Font of Return just as a sideboard card. Or we can take the Return Reveler just in case our curve ends up being really high and we just desperately need a 2-drop. Having 2-drops is certainly important, so we'll go ahead and take that. There was a... let's see. So here we can take either Desecration Plague or Market Festival. And I think I'm going to go with the Desecration Plague. We already have a Consign to Dust, but Market Festival is definitely on the slow side and not really that great unless you're splashing a card like Boulder Fall or Faded Return. This is interesting. Riddle of Lightning and Starfall still in the pack. We can go for Desecration Plague number 2 or Font of Return. I'm going to go with the second Plague, just try and cut off green. And another Land Pads here. And, well, here's the Font of Return. There's also Humbler of Mortals, which is a reasonable 6. I'm going to go with that instead. And we can take the Glisten of Cyclops. So it seems like we settled into 2 fine colors. Blue was certainly an option, although it was more early on when we had a lot of better non-blue options, like Feast of Dreams. So that makes it more difficult. I can guess that this pack is going to be have less green for us because we passed some interesting early green. We did pass some good black, but not as much. And this pack, we're going to go ahead and just take the Grave Robber Spider, I think. This pack is quite deep. There's Fall of the Hammer, Attraction Helix, Nyxborn Eidolon, Bolt of Caranus, Ghostblade Eidolon, Grave Robber Spider, Flutterstep Eidolon, Hero of Eros, and Nyxborn Shieldmate. We've got quite a few reasonable picks. I don't think the Eidolon's going to wheel, but the Wayfinder might, and I'm certainly happy taking the Grave Robber Spider. If you do a quick cost sort, put that, and you see it in moves into our 4-drop slots. It's currently not filled with anything. There's the rare missing here, so we're going to go ahead and take in the 68, which is a reasonable removal. Let's see, taking a look at what we have so far, we can hide these Desecration Plagues. Those are more of a sideboard thing. There's Forlorn Sudama, which gets pretty good. There's a second Retraction Helix, but I like the removal that a 68 provides. It's better when creatures are not attacking, because you know then you can actually target something. You can't really target a creature that's been attacking you for the last few turns. So if we draw it later on in the game, then it ends up being not as good. This pack has Repo to Sown and Tromocratus as the good cards. There's also a Citizen Oathsworn, which can work out, but unfortunately isn't too well suited for our deck. We don't really have any effects that are targeting it. We could wield cards like Grizzly Transformation, but those aren't nearly as good as other options. But as I said before, this pack just really doesn't have too many, so we're gonna go ahead and take the Oathsworn because it's a creature. Again, this is a pretty weak pack. There's a Necrobite or a Fellhide Brawler, or we can take a Swordwise Centaur. Swordwise Centaur makes our mana a little bit more awkward, but if we push black to the splash side, then this gets a lot better. Basically, we move our Farika's Chosen into a 3 or 4 drop, and we focus on green 2 drops. That is kind of what I like doing because you have better creatures overall. Creatures like Swordwise Centaur are just better than Fellhide Brawler. So really, a 3-2 is better than a 2-2 that can't block? Interesting. Tell me more. So the guy to our left is probably not drafting white, I'm just saying. Our pick is going to be Immortal's Resolve. Good with the Oathsworn and okay with our other creatures. Generally, green has big creatures, so if you are able to put the opponent on the back foot, having something like Immortal's Resolve to use on, say, a Humbler of Mortals, that gets pretty good in terms of card advantage that you could provide. The option would be a Marsh Mist Titan, which doesn't really work out too well. Let's hide this Reprisal. Just because it's going to be more black-based for our deck. And here we can take another Oathsworn. Hopefully the Caramash's Favor from our opening pack wheels, if anything, besides the Nyxborn Eidolon. But right now I'm happy with where this is taking us. I generally don't like this guy, but if we can get enough cards to trigger Heroic, then it ends up being okay. I think here we're going to go ahead and take a Favor over a Titan. Can see that there's a lot of red and blue. So it seems like the person to our that we're passing to for the next pack is taking a lot of the cards that we're interested in because we're getting not too much in terms of card quality. You can see that we haven't really any seen any of the very many good green or black cards later on in this. For us, we're gonna go ahead and take the Stezzan Starbreaker. We already have two Desecration Plagues, but Charging Badger is just not a card that we're particularly interested in. Whereas this is more of a sideboard card. All right, so we have one favor already. I think we can probably take another, or we can take the Wayfinder. The Nyxborn Shieldmate and the Deepwater Hypnotist Wield. There was a Retraction Helix, there was also a Hero of Eros, and there were a bunch of black cards. So there was a Dramsara and the Nyxborn Eidolon. So that means that this next pack is going to be a bit unfriendly for us, I think, but Caramash's Favor will be somewhat useful. Oh, I guess the Dramsara was this pack. Well, we can certainly take that over the Satyr Wayfinder. Just in case we end up playing against an aggressive deck. And here we can take either War Chanter of Mogis, but that's pretty unnecessary considering we have two Lampads already doing the same thing and at 5 mana, so we'll go ahead and take the Forsaken Drifter. Hide this Starbreaker. Forsaken Drifter is not ideal. But if we need creatures, then we need creatures. So we got Sky Reaping, and taking a look at what we have so far, we've got a lot of cards that are just not ideal for our main deck, or just playing at all. Forsaken Drifters, we have Marsh Mist Titan here, Caramash's Favor, Nyx Infusion. So this is a bit underpowered for our deck. We really need to get lucky with this last pack and open a lot of stuff.